Welcome back, adventurers.
Hello.
In honor of the newest movie, Wakanda Forever, which was recently released, California Adventure is bringing the celebration into Avengers Campus through some new character appearances as well as new food.
We already know how good the technology is in Wakanda,
yep.
So that should mean their food is even better.
There's not a whole lot being offered, just one Wakanda like Celebration Forever booth, but we expect the menu to be really good. So what are we waiting for? Let's get grubbing and welcome to Dream Park. Just had our first new character appearance here at Avengers Campus, which was M'Baku from the Jabari tribe. And with all of his tribal chanting and drums, I think we've worked up enough of an appetite to head over to Wakanda Forever food booth, where they have some pretty appetizing looking entrees. So let's head over. The first flavor of Wakanda that we're gonna try for the night is the peri peri chicken with yellow jollof rice. I don't know. It kind of looks like a pollo loco to me. It's actually not too bad. It's a little dry on the chicken. Maybe that's why they gave me the lime. Let's see. That chicken definitely took some effort to get down there. It was tasty, but it was definitely on the drier side. Not slow cooked, if I had to guess. It has like a corn kind of taste. It's a little bit on the, mushy side. It's not mushy, but it kind of has a thicker consistency. Really good, reminds me of risotto. I would say this plate is a worth it for sure. I haven't tried the other one yet, but so far so good.
What's the lime for?
I guess to wet the chicken.
If you want some seasoning.
Yep.
Even the lime looks dry.
It's for you, T'Challa.
Damn.
The chicken's red.
That chicken looks, it has a good texture.
That looks not cooked.
Yeah, that's what
I'm saying. You're gonna get sick,
Eddie. It's pretty good chicken. It's not dry either.
It's not dry?
Apparently it looks uncooked, but I'd say it's worth it. It's honestly pretty tasty chicken. Not the juiciest, but it's not dry. Worth it. Nah.
Maybe that's why they give you the lime.
All right, the rice is a wet on it, but the chicken is worth it. Yeah.
All right, so next we have the peanut stew, which actually looks pretty appetizing, not gonna lie. This looks right up my alley. It's called the Moffy? Peanut stew with some like ground spices, tomatoes, black-eyed peas, and then some naan bread on the side. Peanut taste is in there. A little bit of kick. If you're not into spice, probably stay away from this because there is a bit of a kick in there, especially once you get like below the surface. Very flavorful, very good. You gotta try this with the naan bread really quick just to make sure it's a complete dish. Let's see. Naan bread is a little dry. It's a good compliment to the stew, but I would just eat the stew by itself. I didn't even need the bread. But this is worth it. I like it. And we also got the butterfly PT lemonade to go with it, because we gotta wash all this down. Well, maybe we should stir it. So pretty, I don't wanna stir. Oh, I took a sip of the top and it was just like water. It was a little bit diluted, so I think we have to stir it. Oh wow, that's really good. Get this, worth it.
Michael should not have mentioned that there was a kick in this because Halloween's over, but I'm a little spooked. I'm not much of a spice kind of guy. Huh. All right, not too much of a kick, so it's not that bad. But I don't know how to feel about it. It's not disgusting. It tastes pretty good. But I'm not much of a soup guy either. So I can't see myself getting this again. Personally, it's going to be a wait on it. It's not bad, but the pea flavor, the black-eyed peas, I think there's spinach on top here as well. It's not my style. I like my mac and cheese. But I'm gonna try the naan too. Wow, that is some hard naan. I couldn't even. Now the spice is kicking in. I couldn't even bite the naan. What the heck? It was so hard. This is unacceptable. Dry. Hard, like a hockey puck. What would T'Challa say? It's pretty good. It's pretty good. It avenges the soup. It tastes like a strong lemonade. It tastes like Minute Maid. But it's worth it.
Now, even though there's only two food items to choose from and two drink items, one of them being alcoholic at the Wakanda Forever booth over here, there is still one more flavor of Wakanda that we need to try, and you're going to find that over in Avengers Campus at Shawarma Palace 2. They have a special pork wrap over there that maybe could avenge Kenny's soup issues over here. So let's try it out.
Thank you.
So right before you enter into Avengers Campus, you have Shawarma Palace 2 right in front of the Hyperion Theater. But if you turn to your right, you're treated to a spectacle of light that is honoring Wakanda and the fallen King T'Challa.
I mean, purple was already my favorite color, but now it's like even more my favorite color. This is like,
whoa.
You got this Wakanda Forever sign that welcomes you in. Very, very impressive. The lights are pulsing. Ooh. And then you come around the corner and you have the Black Panther, like, kind of like tribute over there. But you can't see it right now because it's better in the daytime. But there is a quote from King T'Challa himself.
Now, we haven't gotten to see the movie yet, but because of the character appearances here in the park, then we're kind of already like spoiled a little bit as to what happens, but we're still going to see the movie. But if you happen to come over to Avengers Campus, make sure to come over to this little area right in between Avengers Campus and the Hyperion Theater, because it's going to make for some great photo ops. Case in point.
I'm amazed by this beautiful scenery. I want to go audition for Black Panther 3 now. I want to be in the movie.
Well, unfortunately, I don't think auditions are happening anytime soon, but you can start with this roasted pork wrap to get you started.
Do you not believe in me? Our final food item from Shawarma Palace 2 is the Wakandan roasted pork wrap. And let me tell you, I don't even know where to even start to bite this thing. It's pretty massive. Consisting of spiced pork, black garlic, and shermoula. I've never had shermoula, but it's pretty strong. Well, first off, let's get in there. Look at that. Now this ain't no tortilla. I wanna know what kind of wrap this is. This looks like a filling piece of bread. Anyway, after breaking through the barrier of bread, you're hit with a ton of flavor coming from the spices and the shermoula, which is surprisingly not that strong on your taste buds, at least my taste buds. So I'd say this is a solid meal, probably my favorite one out of the other food items. The Wakandan roasted pork wrap, worth it for me. Try it.
Okay, I told Kenny, once we open this thing up, this thing looks like it came straight from Taco Bell. You know those like chalupas with the fluffy tortillas, and you open it up and you got like this seasoned meat? Like, this is as like, I don't know, Wakanda had Taco Bell. Let's see what this flavor is all about.
It's called Waco Bell.
I think Kenny already hit it. Roasted pork wrap with some spices, black garlic sauce, and the shermoula, which is like a marinade or relish. And I'm tasting all of it once I bite in. The wrap that they're using, like the, I don't know what exactly the wrap is, but it's like a fluffy tortilla, I call it. Very good consistency. It's not like chewy, it's not too doughy, it's not too crispy. It's perfect just for this. I kind of wish they had like a breakfast version of this, because normally the Shawarma Palace has like a breakfast wrap. I wonder if Wakanda has breakfast wraps too, but otherwise, this is like a solid worth it. Even better than the peanut stew and the chicken thighs over there. This, Taco Bell, get on this, man. I'm super grateful that Wakanda is sharing some of its culture with us here in California Adventure, and they're even adding some more amazing food to the already amazing lineup of tasty treats that you're gonna find alongside Festival of Holidays.
I can't say the Wakandan food was the best, but I'm still grateful. More so impressed by the scenery they had put on display, as well as the show they had put on. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, I'm glad to see some new faces and characters are joining us here in Avengers Campus, and hopefully they're here to stay.
Ow.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, a comment, and subscribe, and we'll catch you guys on the next Dream Park adventure.
Wakanda forever.